Hello, good morning. My name is John Adjeribigbe. I am a lead auditor to various international standards, including ISO 55001 asset management system. I facilitated in both international and local training session, and I believe I'll be able to do justice to this course. I will encourage you to be active in this training. When I mean active, I want you to jointly participate and contribute. You can stop me at any point in time if you have an idea that relates to any of the issues that is mentioned in the course of this training. Now, why is ISO 55001 important? It is important for organizations to be able to manage, establish, implement, maintain, and continually improve their asset management system. Now, asset management system is a system that enables the organization to manage their assets. Now, what is asset according to this standard? According to ISO 55001, assets include physical assets. It doesn't include financial assets. Among others. So it enables organization, it enables competence to manage the asset. 55000 series includes ISO 55000 asset management overview principles and terminology. This has to talk about any terminology you want to understand with respect to asset. You can actually confirm that in ISO 55000. In ISO 55001, you can actually check various things that with respect to the requirement. It is the main requirement to which organization can be certified. Now, so when we talk about requirement, it means the standard requirement or protect of the standard in order for them to be certified. That's what I mean by the requirement. So as the first principle, 5002 is a guideline. Now, if you want to understand the nitty-gritty of implementing and setting up the standard in your organization, you need to understand ISO 55002. So you can have to buy that in order to guide you to implement ISO 55001. Standard to which I'm going to move further. Now, in management with respect to this standard, it is expected that we will comply with various things, including developing policies, strategic asset management plan, and among others, which we'll cover in the course of this training. Developing the plan, the asset management plan will involve you, covering various aspects of the organization, like planning for every aspect, including even, depreciation of assets and how you make sure that the assets are replaced when the maintenance of assets, all of them are covered under the strategic asset management plan. So as an organization, asset management is very, very critical in helping organizations to prevent them losses with regard to asset as a result of losing their asset. So let's move, but I'll just talk briefly about some of them. This include improved financial performance. Now, if you can maintain your assets that they continuously serve you, there is no gap as a result of breakdown in functionality or activities of the organization because of the asset failure, then your financial performance can continuously improve. Now, so that is key and important to managing assets in an organization. Inform asset investment decision. Asset management also help you to make informed decision. Like I said, improper planning of assets, you're able to plan for cases like, let me give you an instance, depreciation. You're able to plan for replacement. You know when your assets will stop serving you. You know when you need to maintain assets and you need to shut down activities. And then in order to prevent regular shutdown, which can come as a result of breakdown, you need to have the planned maintenance period. And all these are covered in this, in the course of asset management. Now, I'll move to other one because of this. Now, like I said, the scope of this standard only covers physical assets and excludes financial assets. like the stock market, among others. So these are not covered within the course of the standards. Now, the standard has 10 clauses, 10 major clauses, which an auditor will audit in the course of getting the organization certified. There are clauses 4 to 10. These are called the requirement. This is what, now what we call requirement, we're talking about the clauses of the standard that the organization must comply with. They must deliberately and intentionally understand the standard, the clauses, and comply with them. One of them is clause 4, which talks about the context of the organization. And during this aspect is where the organization needs to understand the internal and external issue, come up with a particular SWOT analysis with respect to the asset management system. So when I mean SWOT analysis, you come to your strength, weakness, opportunities, and threats. You're able to come up with your what are your internal strength and weaknesses, and what are your external opportunities and threats. All these are to be assessed in the course of implementing the standard. This will lead you to form a strategic management plan to manage your assets strategically. You must also identify interested parties, those that are interested in your activities, directly or indirectly. We call them the stakeholders. That's internal and external stakeholders has to be considered with respect to what do they want and how can you continuously meet their expectation. This has to be developed with, and as well as the scope of the standard. As an organization, you have to also provide adequate leadership for managing assets in the organization. When I mean adequate leadership, we're talking about, making sure that the management team provide the needed support and resources to manage the assets in the organization. And also ensure that there's regular compliance with the requirement of the standards. You need to appoint management representatives to make sure that, okay, the person can actually speak or go to the management and ensure activities or requirements are fulfilled or comply with in the organization. These are broader explanation which I can give later on. Now, I would not start addressing some of this topic with the view of an auditor, not an implementer, because I've been talking about what needs to be done. Now, as an auditor, if you're auditing this standard, you want to confirm if the organization has actually carried out risk assessment, what documentary evidence do they have to show that they have actually conducted risk assessment. You need to interview the management rep and among others, the internal champions in the organization as to what are the risks, how do they come about the risks and opportunities, and to what extent have they been managing and controlling the risk in the organization. Now, risk management is a critical part of asset management because failure to manage risk with assets can actually make you lose some of your assets. Let me give you an instance. An organization that I trained in the past may confirm that actually because they did not do proper inventory of the assets, they forgot to actually identify a particular asset, including in fact it's a flying boat, which is one of the assets. It was not mentioned in their risk assessment, and so there was no plan for it until it sank. Now, when it sank, they now realized, okay, wow, we have lost this asset. Now, that is why risk management is a critical part of asset management. So as an auditor, you need to verify that the organization has properly conducted risk assessment and then have taken precautions to prevent losing their assets. The support. Now, this is clause 7 of the standard. The organization is also actually expected to provide the needed support to achieve asset management. This includes training, the organization ensuring competence among staff to be able to maintain and manage the asset. It also includes awareness, making sure that everybody in the organization understands the importance of affects asset management, their role and contribution to asset management system in the organization, and how to communicate. Also, they need to communicate, which is basically like they need to communicate the internal and national communication, including like in case of maybe damage to assets like fire consuming their building and all the rest, how they have to manage the external communication with the press and all of that, as well as also internally how to communicate, let's say, the internal policy for an example. So as an auditor, you need to verify that this is done adequately in the organization. You need to check the necessary documentation to show that people are trained and competent. You need to show the awareness record to show that people go through awareness and understand what their role are in the asset management system. They need to understand their quality policy. So you need to interview individuals in the organization as to the understanding of their asset management policy in the organization. So these, among others, are what an auditor needs to verify in the course of auditing the standard. Now, clause 8 is one of the major important aspects of it, which is talked about the operation of the asset management system. Now, in operating the asset management system, the organization is expected to provide the needed control. Most of the control that are generated from the risk assessment has to be implemented at this point. And then as an organization, ensuring the proper compliance, purchasing the needed equipment, training the necessary staff, among others, are part of control that has to be in place to ensure that you are adequately managing your assets in the organization. In doing this, the organization is putting in place proper control systems. Now, it is also one of the critical points of asset management is also the management of change. The reason for change management is that a wrong decision in changing assets can actually lead to loss, a gross loss that is not, irreparable loss, maybe if I have to call it that way. Now, because when you talk about asset management, failure to make the right decision can actually cost you a lot. For example, an organization tried to change the brand of the vehicle, and then they invested in a different type of vehicle, different lesson, instead of using Benz for their activity, they decided to go for less in Lexus for the activities. And then without considering the consequences, and they invested a lot, like buying over 100 vehicles. The example shared from one of my trainees is that even the organization discovered that the vehicle could not go, they have to go like 100 kilometers before they get there. 80% of the vehicle will have broken down. They have to tow them back to the various, to the head office, because they wanted to actually dispatch them to the branches. But they found out that they made a mistake. Now, these are irreparable, because if you buy a vehicle today and it breaks down, you cannot, even if you have warranty or the rest, they will just repair and you make some losses. They will just repair for you and give you back. But if you have considered the risk, your level of activity that will impact on the vehicle, you should have known the type of vehicle that will be suitable for your activity. This is what must be considered in management of change. So as an auditor, you need to consider how change are being properly controlled, who authorizes change, what are the process of authorizing change? Do they conduct proper risk assessment before carrying out risk assessment? The management of change. So these are what, among others, are what is considered in effective management of change in the organization. Performance evaluation. As an auditor, you need to verify if the organization monitor their risk, among others, because the standard does not state what must be monitored. But as an organization, you must identify what needs to be monitored. And as a simple case, I would say that one of those things that must be monitored includes your objective. That's what are your asset management objectives. Are you achieving them? The strategic plan that is reached or agreed from the beginning when you formed your your SWOT analysis. The strategic implementation plan has to be controlled and monitored here. You need to monitor and verify to what extent are you achieving all of this. Internal audit has to be conducted at annual interview. You need to verify the internal audit record, whether it has been done and when it has been done, and what are the outcome of the reports of the audit. Now, from the report, have they carried out necessary corrective action to make sure that the lapses or gaps have been, corrected? I mean, they've taken action, corrective action to mitigate or prevent the occurrence of such action as an auditor. Thank you for your time.